Have you ever watched a movie or TV show and wondered, how does that technology work?
Absolutely.
Well, I know a blockchain when I see one. Today's episode covers crypto faucets, hardware wallets, transparency, and deflation, as well as busting a big inflation myth. Nano, Dogecoin, and ARK are also featured in this episode too. This is the Blockchains of In Time, presented by MarketSquare, the new homepage for the decentralized web. The 2011 movie In Time, starring Justin Timberlake and Amanda Seyfried, lives rent-free in my mind. Granted, it doesn't make a lot of sense.
Why are you laughing?
It plays out more like if the WB made Equilibrium, starring James Bond and Paris Hilton, who decided to become Bonnie and Clyde for some reason. However, I love this movie anyway, because it has three things going for it. Very powerful moments, very novel concepts, and Justin Timberlake, because he's my boy, and he's been giving Justins everywhere a good name for decades.
You're my boy!
Thank you, sir.
It's the novel concepts of In Time that we'll be diving into today. So let's put on our
suit and tie
and start
bringing sexy back.
Today's gonna be a good day.
In Time presents a scenario where time is money and broke people die. Genetic engineering has stopped the aging process at 25.
Happy 50th.
50. That's right.
Yeah, 25 for the 25th time.
Oh, I was sure I'd have a grandchild by now.
Time is now the world currency, and you can buy goods and services with your time.
That'll be 8.5 weeks.
What the fuck?
Everyone has biological clocks that can transact with each other as well as external devices. If you can earn more time than you spend on life or goods and services, you can live forever.
Because everyone wants to live forever.
However, for the system to function as intended, one biological second must always equal one biological second. This means that counterfeiting biotime can't be possible for the system to remain intact. Biotime can be created, but only when a new human is born. There are no time hackers in this movie.
It's hacking time.
Nor is there a Federal Reserve of Time creating it and issuing it. In the movie, it's just globally accepted that biotime currency is absolute, and the only way for someone to get more of it is to transact. This reminds me of something. What was it?
That's right, the square hole.
What? No, blockchains. You can't counterfeit crypto. Each Bitcoin on the Bitcoin blockchain is authentic and verifiable.
Interesting.
Also, while biotime is issued by being born, Bitcoins are issued through a process called mining. In mining, powerful computers solve complex equations to secure the network. And the creation of new coins stops completely in the year 2140.
This is the last one, dude.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, well, I think I should get it. I got it.
Now, you're already watching a video about blockchains, so maybe you already know that stuff. After all, they basically teach it in Bitcoin kindergarten. What you may not know is that for some other cryptocurrencies, that mystical zero emission year of 2140 has actually already come and gone.
What do you got?
Nano is one such example, and there are actually a few reasons why the system in the movie reminds me of Nano specifically.
Let me show you a few things.
When Nano first launched, people obtained it by solving CAPTCHAs online to be awarded with Nano from something called a crypto faucet. A crypto faucet rewards visitors to a website with free cryptocurrency. While there are dozens of faucets for various cryptocurrencies out there, including ARK faucets by delegates Biz Classic and Dell on the ARK public network, Nano used faucets as the primary distribution method in the beginning of the coin's launch. Pretty unique and clever, if you ask me. Not only that, but you had to prove you're a human to get those sweet, sweet Nano coins.
Who are you?
You.
No, not me, you.
Yes, I am you.
In the same way, the bioclock technology in the movie only awards the initial free year to a bona fide human. Let's just suppose it's a non-removable, tamper-proof implant that a human embryo absorbs that tracks all biosignals and combines with DNA to create a unique digital profile that doubles as a cryptographic private key for transactions.
Really spectacular. Spared no expense.
Look, I'm sorry. It just really bugs me that this movie tells me nothing about how this technology actually works.
Who has time?
There's another way that the biotime system reminds me of Nano. Transactions are peer-to-peer, and we can see biotime leaving one person's balance and transferring to the others in near real time. Nano transactions are near instant as well. In fact, there's a really cool video where Nano users send one Nano coin through over a dozen contact points all over the world in just a scooch over 60 seconds.
It's fast.
It's the first time I've ever seen a blockchain relay race, and it was a very clever demonstration of Nano's abilities.
Clever girl.
A third similarity between the BioTime system and Nano is the lack of fees. In the movie, two people could endlessly transact between each other without fees raking away at both balances. In the Nano video earlier, the one coin remained intact when it got back to its starting point in San Francisco. No fees.
And free! Free! Free!
Oh, what? There's another similarity I found between Nano and the BioTime system in the movie. Since people being born is the only way that BioTime currency enters the system, this means that blockchain nodes do not get any BioTime block rewards. Check out our blockchain terms video on block rewards to learn more. Well, check this out. Nano nodes do not receive block rewards either. Nano node operators run nodes solely to help Nano adoption and keep it secure. As it turns out, this totally checks out within the world of the movie because immortality is dependent on this BioTime blockchain, and by running nodes, people are supporting the system that grants them the opportunity to gain prosperity and live forever.
This is merely Darwinian capitalism.
In the movie, I noticed something interesting. There are some cases where people can steal or confiscate time from your bioclock without your express consent, which is a huge system flaw, by the way. I mean, anyone can just grapple you while you're asleep or just walking down the street, robbing you and killing you simultaneously.
You're gonna have a bad time.
However, people under the age of 25 have 1 year of time on their bioclock that is frozen.
You got a minute?
What are you talking about, Maya? You have a whole year.
Not a year I can use yet.
This time lock feature plays into my little blockchain narrative flawlessly, because time locks are also a thing in blockchain networks. For example, in March of 2020, the ARK blockchain upgraded to version 2.6, which included a technology called HTLC Smart Bridge on its development network. HTLC stands for Hashed Time Lock Contract and allows someone to sign a transaction that freezes funds on the chain. Check out our blockchain terms video about HTLC to learn more. When a bioclock is first activated, it self-executes a time lock transaction set to expire when the person turns 25. And that has a very blockchain-y feel to it.
Neat!
The main driving force behind a lot of the more dramatic events in the movie is the ability for anyone to see how much time someone has left. It's right there, embedded directly within the person's arm. Is the truth stranger than fiction, though?
There's a new trend in biohacking, which is inserting LEDs underneath the skin.
Turns out, yes it is. In one sense, this transparency is similar to blockchain technology, since all the balances on the network can be viewed using a special website called a Block Explorer. However, at the same time, blockchains are slightly different, since you can't readily identify who's attached to which balances on the blockchain. We don't walk around with LEDs in our arms that show everybody how many bitcoins we have.
I too am very, very wealthy.
So here's the thing. In the movie, there are these time cops. No, not like that. In this movie, they're called timekeepers, and they investigate time-related crimes. Not normal crimes.
I don't concern myself with justice.
But offenses like time theft or other crimes involving time currency.
I keep time.
Think FinCEN, but with guns and pursuit vehicles and T-1000-like stamina. Even though the timekeepers have advanced camera systems and even a situation room for monitoring currency in each district, they seem to have a hard time resolving specific balances to specific identities. This observation reinforces BioTime as blockchain. A rich nihilist in the beginning of the movie, let's call him Trusty Funson, gives a gift of over a century to our boy, Jay Timbers, then runs out his bioclock intentionally.
Oh!
Somebody!
He needs some milk!
But the timekeepers need to resort to facial ID to eventually identify JT. They can't just type in their system, hey, who did Trusty Funson give that time to? Oh, it was Will Salas, the main character of the movie? Let's go talk to that guy. Will's financial activity isn't automatically tied to his identity because the BioTime network is pseudonymous.
What the hell's that supposed to mean?
That means the numerical data is public, but the identifying data is not necessarily tied to it. And do you know what else is pseudonymous?
It's gonna be
blockchain.
I'm sorry, is that funny? Are you stand-up comic? Is that what you do now?
In the movie, BioTime is simultaneously inflating and deflating its circulating supply. BioTime inflates every time a person turns 25, and the 1 year of BioTime they were given by the system enters circulation and becomes fluid currency. BioTime deflates every time a person over 25 lives for 1 second, and that 1 second is destroyed, or burned, forever. Nano, in the most technical sense, is actually a deflationary currency. Now, Dogecoin, on the other hand, is an inflationary cryptocurrency. Every time the Dogecoin miners add a block to the blockchain, 10,000 Dogecoins are created. Unlike Bitcoin, which stops inflating in the year 2140, Dogecoins will inflate in perpetuity. But there's an inflation myth that I hear people using against Dogecoin, and I'm going to bust that myth right now. You hear that, Dogecoin? I got your back. So people would say something like this. Oh, fiat currencies like USD inflate forever. They have an unlimited supply, and countries like Venezuela, Argentina, and Zimbabwe have shown us that inflation is bad. Dogecoin inflates forever, therefore Dogecoin is bad. Dogecoin has an unlimited supply, and that means Dogecoin is bad.
Next.
That's a joke, right?
This is a high school level argument that takes specific statements worded a certain way to be true, and then makes a direct comparison to other truths to conclude with same, same. Dogecoin and fiat currencies are both inflationary, so in that way they are the same.
But different!
Fiat inflation can be quite unpredictable, because the powers that be have the ability to create any amount they want at any time. Like, oh, there's a war, gotta print a lot of money. Oh, there's an oil crisis, gotta print a lot of money. Oh, there's a pandemic, gotta print a lot of money. Dogecoin is decentralized, unlike fiat currency. If Dogecoin inflation were to change, the miners must agree first and accept the new code. This means Dogecoin inflation is more likely to remain the same. Dogecoin inflation is cryptographically fixed at 10,000 new Dogecoins per minute. This 10,000 Dogecoin block reward will never end. While that technically makes Dogecoin an infinite supply coin, when it's expressed as an annual inflation percentage, the inflation rate is actually going down towards zero all the time. This is vastly different to fiat currencies, where the supply tends to increase exponentially, causing a rapid decay in the purchasing power of fiat currencies. Take a look at this graph from howmuch.net.
I mean, I have graphs. I have some graphs I can show you.
I made these on my computer.
Now, let's compare the inflation of USD and Dogecoin. At 10,000 new Dogecoins per minute, a fixed number of 5.256 billion Dogecoins are created annually. That seems like a lot, but compared against the current supply of 129 billion, that's only 4.1% inflation rate over the next 12 months. For reference, that inflation rate is about 8 times lower than the inflation rate of the dollar for 2020. Did I just blow your mind?
I'll take that as a maybe.
And if we calculate Dogecoin inflation rate for another year, it becomes 3.9%, an even lower number than 4.1. The Dogecoin inflation rate goes down each year.
And knowing is half the battle.
G.I. Doge! So, we have just one more important topic to cover in our blockchain breakdown of the movie In Time? Oh yeah, that's what this video is about.
Since when?
I was going to talk about this next topic in the Blockchains of Altered Carbon, the inaugural episode of this show, but I knew I would eventually be covering this movie, so I'm talking about it here. In the world of In Time, we see characters with these handheld devices. Their sole purpose is to store the BioTime currency. In fact, our hero, Will, helps manufacture these devices as part of his job. Now, I don't know why Will manufactures these sensitive electronic devices in a dirty factory that looks like it should be churning out rear differentials for SUVs, so don't ask me. These devices, just like the ones shown in Altered Carbon, are cryptocurrency hardware wallets. A hardware wallet is a blockchain industry term, referring to a physical device that stores and secures cryptocurrencies and other crypto assets. They provide a security barrier between your funds and your personal devices. As it turns out, this is a critical device for people living in the movie. Otherwise, they would all have to walk around wearing their life savings at all times right on their arm. And since people can rob you of your time without your consent, These wallet devices can save you from getting robbed so bad that you become broke and or dead.
You're having a bad day? Did you die?
I got shot.
But did you die?
There's a wide selection of good hardware wallets to choose from that store and secure cryptocurrencies well. The Ledger Nano is a great example, since it's easy to use and affordable too. According to Ledger.com, Ledgers are the most popular hardware wallets, with over 2 million units sold worldwide. Private keys remain protected on a certified secure chip inside the device. You can store over 1,500 supported crypto assets on the device and broadcast transactions using the Ledger Live Companion app. The Ledger Nano X is listed at $119, and its predecessor, the Ledger Nano S, is only $59, with both available on the Ledger website. A different company, NGRAVE, is trying to take hardware wallets to the next level. The NGRAVE Zero is a device with a large color screen and touted as 100% offline. That means no USB, no Bluetooth, no Wi-Fi, not even NFC.
But what they built was extraordinary.
That's why it's called the Zero. Their website says that there are zero online attack vectors. Since nothing can penetrate this hardware wallet, the NGRAVE Zero can keep crypto very, very secure.
My function is to keep Summer safe, not keep Summer being, like, totally stoked about, like, the general vibe and stuff.
So how can you broadcast transactions to a blockchain if you can't digitally access the wallet? The NGRAVE Zero cleverly uses QR codes, combined with its mobile companion app, NGRAVE Liquid, to accept pre-signed transactions embedded within the QR code. Your mobile device then relays the signed transaction to the blockchain. That means you don't have to connect the NGRAVE Zero to any device for any reason to broadcast transactions.
Sometimes my genius is, it's almost frightening.
The NGRAVE Zero clocks in at a pretty penny though. That's higher than the price of 3 Ledger Nano X's. However, some avid crypto enthusiasts may sleep better at night due to its features and benefits.
A small price to pay for salvation.
If you're not subscribed, now's the time to do that. Check out our other episodes like The Blockchains of Ready Player One, Black Mirror, and Altered Carbon, or go to marketsquare.io to discover and connect with your favorite blockchain-powered projects and businesses. See you next time.